from the Ericsson Globe in Stockholm, Sweden. What a big night of fights for the UFC. I'm Brendan Fitzgerald. I'm with Dan Hardy. Dan, in our main event, Anthony Lionheart Smith, not the first time he's come into enemy territory and got his hand raised. Speak about that performance that he had.
It was a very, very good performance from Anthony Smith, because obviously a quick turnaround after the John Jones fight. He came out against Gustafsson knowing full well he had to chase Gustafsson down, and for the first two rounds, he did a good job. Pinned him up against the fence, you know, tried to work some strikes, but as always, the elusiveness of Gustafsson started to get him back into the fight in the third round. But then that takedown exchange in the fourth allowed Anthony Smith to get to the back, and he was just patient with his time. You know, he crept that arm under the neck and got the tap. Beautiful performance.
Yeah, and he says he doesn't get enough credit for the black belt that he has on the ground. His last two wins by submission against Volkan Uzdemir, which we saw in Canada and in Sweden here tonight. On the other side, Alexander Gustafsson goes out unhappy, and now has to find something else to do, because he retired after the fight, dropped his gloves in the octagon. I think surprising a lot of us, including you, who are standing right next to him. Your thoughts?
Yeah, you know, as soon as I saw him taking the tape off, I thought to myself, is there a consideration that he's going to leave his gloves in the octagon tonight? And there was a moment where he kind of looked at the gloves like he was hesitant to let them go. But then finally, you know, the show's over. He dropped the gloves to the canvas and announced his retirement. I mean, you know, it's a sad moment. I'm sure there was a lot of emotion and frustration involved in the decision as well. But I did kind of get the impression that, you know, it was one of two ways this fight was going to go. If he won, he was back in and he was going to run at a title shot. And if it went the opposite way, then he was going to hang him up. And maybe that's the right decision for him if there's a hesitation.
Well, he's had so much success in this building. First time he lost was tonight in the Ericsson Globe. But he's done so much for the sport in Sweden and in Europe and really across the world as well. So hats off and a congratulations to him on retirement. But coming up in the light heavyweight division, no shortage of prospects. And they were on display tonight, including in the co-main event, Aleksandar Rakic putting Vienna, Austria on the map with a head kick knockout inside the first minute of Jimi Manuwa.
A highlight reel head kick knockout as well. And a kick that I don't think Manuwa was expecting to be caught with. And it just goes to show you the length of the legs on Aleksandar Rakic. He threw that kick and he caught Jimmy right at the end of it. And it was a perfectly timed kick. You know, it's so difficult to land a head kick and get the perfect knockout like that. And with a knockout like that, everyone's going to watch that. We'll see that several times this week. Every light heavyweight in the division will have seen that, and they'll know what he's capable of now. So just like Anthony Smith won't be underestimated with his ground game, Aleksandar Rakic won't be underestimated at range.
And the light heavyweight division shouldn't be underestimated by anybody who likes the sport of mixed martial arts, because in the UFC right now at 205, it is as good as it gets. We don't want to forget this from earlier in the night in the prelims. Leonardo Santos offer about 3 years, 32 months to be exact. 2016 was the last time we saw him in the octagon. He comes out in emphatic fashion and knocks out Stevie Ray. What a performance there.
An incredible showing from him. And, you know, again, showing the reach advantage put to full effect. I mean, he clipped Stevie Ray right on the end of that right hand and then I think was overwhelmed in the moment and just took off running out of the octagon and did, a couple of laps of the arena before he made his way back in. I want to see him fighting regularly, though. That's what I keep saying about Leo Santos. He's a talented fighter. He's a dangerous individual, one of the best ground games in the sport. But if we're only seeing him every 32 months, people were going to forget about him. You know, we need to see him active. We need to see him three times a year at least.
Well, the traveling show continues. Yeah, you said it. He'll be 40 next year. The traveling show continues next week in Chicago. It's UFC 238. Two titles are on the line, count them two, including in our main event. Henry Cejudo fought off TJ Dillashaw earlier this year from trying to become a champ. He will now move up to 135 pounds to try to be a champ. Against Marlon Moraes.
And a great matchup as well. Marlon Moraes coming off that emphatic win over Sun Tzu. Moraes is at the stage of his career now where he's ready for that title shot. And he knows it in his head. His team know it around him. Unfortunately, he's got a big fight. You know, he's got Cejudo coming up, an Olympic gold medalist, a world champion at flyweight. It's a big opportunity for Moraes to not only be a dominant champion in that fight, but also to kind of open his options up for some more super fights. I feel like he's that kind of performer. And I feel like with an emphatic win over Cejudo, picking up a title, get that wrapped around his waist, he can start calling people out left, right, and center, and he's that kind of guy.
Well, and also Marlon Moraes has no shortage of highlights on his record as well. He has been absolutely rolling to get this title shot, and it goes down in the main event in Chicago. Just before that, the other title that's on the line is in the women's flyweight division. Valentina Shevchenko looks to defend her belt, and she will do that against Jessica Ai.
And the challenge with Jessica Ai is the wrestling game. She's a strong wrestler. She's a grinder. She'll make it very untidy. But Shevchenko is a dangerous striker with an excellent ground game as well. So I feel like Shevchenko controls the extent of the spectrum of mixed martial arts, whereas Jessica Rai, she makes it untidy and she controls the middle range, the wrestling. So she needs to lean on that heavy and start with a fast pace if she's going to get that belt.
Well, since that division was installed into the UFC, Valentina Shevchenko has had her name circled. She then became champion like many people expected. She will be a huge favorite against Jessica Rai, who's from Cleveland. She'll be having some crowd on her side in the Windy City. And also, the people's main event. It is at lightweight. It is Donald Cowboy Cerrone, who's a month and a few days after going five full rounds in Ottawa over Ally Aquinta, and what a performance that was. He gets the return of Tony Ferguson, a fight nobody can wait for.
Nobody can wait for. And this
we're going to have to, unfortunately.
I know. But this is a new Cowboy. This is a new Donald Cerrone that we're seeing. Ever since the birth of his son, Danger, he's just had there's been a new fire in his strikes. You know, he's been attacking more aggressively. He's been focused on getting the win instead of just being in there and fighting because he loves the adrenaline rush. All of a sudden, there's a purpose to it now. You know, he's trying to build something for his son, and you can see how proud he is. He carries him into the octagon, he's got his headphones and his poncho on. I mean, it's a big part of his motivation. And I think that might be the missing piece for Cowboy Cerrone, the thing that's kept him from getting a world title in the past. I think that additional extra little motivation might be enough to get him all the way to the world title.
Well, it's been a great 2019 so far for the MMA leader. On June 1st, Anthony Smith hands Alexander Gustafsson a loss. What else do we get in June? We get Contender Series coming back. We're in Chicago next week. International Fight Week just over a month away. I love when spring turns to summer in the UFC. For Dan, I'm Brendan. See you next time.